Right now, we're just using 1D raw depth, that's it. But now this one here, start moving to 3D, and what's the value on that? I'm kind of intended or interested in creating the future. So this one here, the idea there is, well, this is more close to a real situation. In the past, a lot of people that to analyze the roadway and vehicle loss control, basically they're using what? They're using basically simulated surface and in the office to simulate those. Now you have a true surface now. That's become quite valuable and useful now. So I have almost one PhD student now working on and one master finished the degree already. They're using the casting, which is about a manufacturer company from the car industry. So we use this one here to simulate what is the vehicle response and what's the situation. So now you have this one here, you can construct. And just last week, well, the week before last week, we got a call from the FHW, Terminal Fairbank Research Center. They say we have heard people say you have the true surface there. And can I work with you guys? I say, well, what you want? He said that hydroplaning is a big issue. And we are a hydrology group in FHWA, Terminal Fairbank. And then, so they sent me a manual, a handbook. It's called Highway Drainage Design. So they say, well, a lot of people know this is out of date. And all we can do is simulate the surface in our lab. But really, we really wanted to have a true surface there to go with our simulation so we can refine that main closer to the real. So we can refine the entire the highway, roadway, drainage design manual. So anyway, I just wanted to mention it to you. Some of those is not new, it's happening now. So we say, okay, we'll work with you guys. We'll reconstruct and generate a 3D surface, 3D texture. And so the previous one, actually earlier when we worked on, we also have a student work almost three semesters from mechanical engineering. They work at Michelin, tire company. Sometimes they related to fuel consumption too. So related to texture, et cetera. So those are the ones that lots of related areas. But get to the original point. Why did 3D become a mainstream? If you look at the current technology, actually even up to now, nowadays, the texture is one device to measure. One device. The cracking is 2D imaging. A lot of people are still using 2D imaging to analyze cracking. Second device. Third device, major 14. Fourth device, like a G-Dot purchased last year, or the year before last year, almost seven rock, the rock bar measure, 5 point, or I think 5 point or 3 point rock bar measure. Basically, you have the laser 5 point, and you measure the shape of rocking. But thinking about this one here, I have not 4 point, 5 point. I have 4,000 point. Basically, I have a true surface. So I think this year they published, the FHWA published a manual, a report saying that the current technology, raw bar, had a lot of inconsistency, error. So in a way that you can see, but in this 3D technology, it's just one data, one raw, that's it. You collect one time with high resolution, you extract it with different wavelength. The data of the picture, the data of the cracking, also for rotting, the rot depth. As the one I showed it to you, when you look at the bigger wetland, that's rotting. So that's so there's a fair amount of PhD and master students, and they already graduated. They kind of make the strict cracking, the reach to valley depth, and then also folding, and so using this technology. And again, I think the focus that we have, we still focus a lot in omega detection. So like this one here, that's basically say, well, how did you omega detect the condition, extract them? So that's still our focus. And we extend the technology to UAV because we start thinking about, hey, we already have intelligence. And UAV, this is the second version of UAV we have. And basically just bring us from 1D to 3D, that's it. So this one here is showing that this is second version here. And then you can see that this one here capture or make it detect the split limit And similarly, if you look at this one here, that this is UAB, and then you aiming down, you collect the payment. So in the payment there, that you'll be able to extract the condition. So in a way that you can extract the condition there. So this is the one that basically for that. But certainly you can expand that to 3D because in a way that in this case here, that the bridge is a lot of time, this is a Chattahoochee River, I-75. So a lot of time in this location here is not easy to access because of water. And so in a way that this one here, you can access the bridge condition and you can have a UAV there. And then you can move the object forward there. But I think when you get a tons of UAV image, what are you going to do? Well, either you manually review those 10 million image or process. So our focus is still consistently. We did not develop the hardware. And although we integrate some of the hardware, but I think our focus is still how to turn the data into information. That's still our research focus. The last question here, this is probably less. What's the status now? Is that just research stage? No, we implement those already. So now we kind of use the entire interstate highway, implement that. So this year, the commissioner, I think the project that we have, implementation, it's been select 2017 ASHTO High Value Research Award. So I think Commissioner, GDAC Commissioner is going to go there to get the award. So this is the one that we applied that in the entire interstate highway. So you can see this is probably the first time, not only Georgia, there are a lot of state DOT do not have a complete inventory of science because it's so tedious to get that. So now we're using an image automating process again. So for the entire interstate highway, now we know where is the SSR, 22,000. And then what's different type, and where's the overhead sign, and what's their condition? Now you know that. And then this is the one that you assess the payment condition to. At that point in time, we focus on asphalt, so concrete portion there, which is hopefully this year we can complete the concrete portion. So with that, I will stop it here. Since probably we don't have time to get into the innovation. Any quick questions? Since we kind of still have 10 minutes, 12 o'clock, and another class is coming in. Any questions? No? No? Okay. If not, then we'll stop it here then. Okay, thank you.